आई एम संचिता दास फ्रॉम द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इंग्लिश सूर्यसेन महाविद्यालय शिलीगुड़ी। आई एम गोइंग टू स्पीक ऑन विलियम वर्ड्सवर्थ्स पोएम ओड ऑन इंटीमेशंस ऑफ इमॉर्टलिटी। द ओड बिगिन्स विद अ नोट ऑफ रिग्रेट दैट द सेलेशियल लाइट और ब्यूटी व्हिच द पोएट फाउंड इन द डेज ऑफ हिज चाइल्डहुड इन एवरी कॉमन ऑब्जेक्ट ऑफ नेचर हैज डिसअपीयर्ड इन हिज मैच्योर एज। टू व्हाट एवर beautiful object he now turns, namely the rainbow, the rose, the moonlight, sunlight, etc., he realizes that a glory has passed away from them. Today in the spring season, when all art is gay and men and animals are full of mirth, the mind of the poet is saddened by the sense of this loss of glory from the earth. The poet is determined to shake off these feelings of sadness and partake of the spirit of joy that he finds all around him. But the sight of a tree or a field or a flower in the scene of joy pathetically reminds him of his loss of the visionary gleam in nature. The poet now proceeds to account for this disappearance of the visionary gleam. His view is that our souls existed in heaven before our earth in this world. We come directly from God, and when the soul is born in this world, it still retains the memory of prenatal existence. Hence, in childhood, when the memory of the prenatal life is still fresh and vivid, the soul finds the celestial light shining on the objects of this earth. As the child grows in numbers, in years, he recedes farther from heaven, and the celestial light begins to fade. In youth, traces of this light are still there, though in a dimmed form. At last, in manhood, it completely dies away and all objects in nature appear commonplace. The earth, to play her part in making her dear child, that is man, completely forgetful of the heavenly glory. The child moves in a world of his own making. His days are spent in imitation of the ways and the manners of his elders. He plays various parts in this stage of the world, but the poet feels a pang to think the world will soon lay its hold on the child when he will grow up. Why should he then anticipate the ills of life which are bound to come in course of time? The poet now glorifies childhood and the child. The child is the best philosopher and seer, who has an intuitive perception of the higher truths of human life, which mature man is toiling in vain to attain. He never for a moment forgets that his soul is immense and immortal. He lives in constant communion with God, but such a blessed state will not last for long. The years will bring upon him the weight of customs and conventions of the society, which will bow him down to earth, and his beautiful vision will fade into the light of common good. Yet all is not lost. The shadowy recollections of the glorious past come to the soul, though not habitually but occasionally, in the years of manhood. Childhood is to be praised not for its delight and liberty, but for its idealism, which makes things appear as unreal and unsubstantial, and the world a fairy place. It is this idealism of the childhood which is the source of all our knowledge and the master light of our vision. It has ample power to sustain and cherish man in the midst of these perplexing realities of life. Nothing can suppress it. Hence, it is that in moments of calm and tranquility, our memory have fitful glimpses of the eternity from which we came to this earth. Hence, the poet does not repine for the loss of the visionary gleam of childhood, but rather finds strength in that remains. His mind is completely attuned to the spirit of joy prevailing around him. He finds enough compensation for this loss in the new acquisition of a sympathetic understanding of nature, in the soothing thoughts that spring from the contemplation of human suffering, and lastly in the philosophic mind which years have brought him. As a result, he has learned to look upon nature with sober eyes. His love of nature is no less ardent. Even the commonest objects of nature now give him thoughts and feelings which are so deep that they cannot find adequate expressions even in tears. Thank you.
This and other episodes of Radio EduPods, Radio for Learning, are available on Listen to My Radio app at 6 p.m. from Monday to Friday and at 6 a.m. from Tuesday to Saturday. All episodes are available on Salesian TV YouTube channel. Share, like and subscribe Salesian TV, the ultimate learning resource channel.